man. The Huskies represent the perfect choice for me to continue my maturation as a man. Look forward to winning, but to continue my skills for the next level. Yes. So I want to thank everyone for tuning in, and I better see everybody.
Everybody.
In a navy blue and red when I take the court next year for UConn. All right? Show that back.
Yes.
Ray Ray. Swish. Ray Ray. Swish.
We didn't Husky.
Frequency vibrations. Well, you know that little dance he does? He came out doing that.
Freaking vibe.
Oh, my goodness.
College basketball fans, this is where you want to be, right here on 2K Sports. Some great action ahead, and we're happy to have you here along with us Longhorns, taking on the UConn Huskies.
There is no feeling like a packed house on a college campus. You can just feel the electricity in the air as two major colleges go head-to-head on the hardwood.
And even though this game isn't a must-have game, it feels like a tournament game, a one-and-done type situation. Both of these programs know that a win here could be huge for them as they get ready to make a run in March.
Now let's take a look at the Longhorns' opening lineup. Ellis is out there with Edwards. Then there's Doherty. Then it's Turner. And it's Ford in at the four slot.
You know, so often we can forget that these players are student-athletes. I mean, Freak does not have that problem. He's an amazing student off the floor and is very dedicated in the classroom.
And how about Freak with a 4.0 GPA, an honor student in high school, and has carried that same work ethic to college as well as he prepares for his games. He truly embodies what it means to be a student athlete.
So he comes up empty, missing both. Well, you could pick any team in the NBA and name a Husky that played for him at some point. UConn has had a big impact. Back down the NBA.
UConn has had a lot of NBA talent pass through their school. I mean, it speaks volumes about how well they are able to develop talent and win championships. Mm-hmm.
Now, Freak. Martin kicks to Livingston. Keith against Ellis. Martin with the bucket.
I really think that's the area they want to work the ball into, and it takes passing like that to get it done.
On defense, the Huskers pass to Dorden. They double him with Freak. It's Ellis on the wing. Up top, Edwards. Here's Ford. And good work on the boards. They pick up the second chance points. Ford's got his second bucket. And here's Freak. Splitter sets a screen. Freak with it. His second shot goes in. Off to a good start, 2 for 2.
Yeah, heads up aggressive play right there. Saw the smaller man on him and took it straight to the basket.
To the paint. Ford, no luck.
You can see he just rushed that a little bit. Lost the focus, I think.
Joseph, the pass to Livingston. He feeds it to Joseph, and it's going to be out of bounds. The Huskies will retain possession. Different look for Texas. Texas trails by 8. On the floor for UConn. Livingston, he's in at the point. Also, Keefe out there. And it's Splitter in at the 5, down low.
And with Freak, he takes a lot of pride in where he hails from. Didn't grow up with a silver spoon in his hand by any means, and his family cheers him on from Harlem.
And Greg, you can see it in this game. I mean, we're all a product of where we've been, our environment, our experiences. And with Freak, he doesn't take anything for granted. Some of the very best players of all time have come from the projects like Freak. And he takes pride in playing for Harlem when he's on the court.
Shot clock at 5. Doherty with the bucket.
And that's one of his strengths, knocking down those long-range jump shots.
Roski's leading by 5. Here's Livingston, rebounded by Ellis.
Well, in Texas, the Longhorns are known for their football history, actually all over the country. They have an impressive basketball alumnus list, too, though. A lot of pros have come out of Texas.
Inside, here's Keith. That drops and it comes off the assist from Livingston.
Wow, fired that bounce pass in there. Beautiful.
Texas. Trails by 7. Edwards inside. He's covered by Livingston. Good! Turner's got his first bucket of the night. With the Texas Longhorn program, they've had a lot of NBA talent through the years. Greg Durant being the biggest name, but there are plenty.
Yeah, LaMarcus Aldridge is not far behind in terms of his impact. Tristan Thompson, DJ Augustine, Avery Bradley. Been a lot of great Longhorns to play in our league.
Doubled by Livingston. And Doherty kicks to Edwards. Out to Turner. Ellis, the pass to Edwards. Back to Ellis. Puts up a 3. Here's Ford. And the dunk to finish it off. A beauty.
And, guys, isn't it great to see a player who works that hard on the glass at both ends?
Well said, G. That's the way he has built, you know, his reputation. Hard grinding away, 100% effort all the time.
And, you know, Kevin, all that effort pays off. How many of those spectacular putback jams do we see from this guy? A bunch.
Here is Edwards, pass to 4. Shoots from the elbow. Misses off the left iron. They contest the game here as we end the first half. The Huskies on top. They lead by 5. And time now for the halftime break with the second half of basketball right around the corner. Hello and welcome back. This is College Basketball on 2K Sports. And if you're just tuning in, this is Kevin Harlan along with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg as we get set for the second half.
Guys, we had a tight game through the first half. I think we'll see more of the same coming out of the break.
And it's just going to take one big run for one of these teams to establish control. If we can get hot, this team has a great chance of coming away with the victory.
On the court for the Longhorns, they've got Edwards, also Ellis out there. Turner is out there with Doherty, and it's Ford in a power forward position.
And, you know, we've seen a lot of great point guards over the years, and Freak is right at the top for me. The things he can do with the ball are special, and he knows how to control the flow of the game, too. He's not only highly skilled, but he's a maestro in orchestration.
And it's really interesting. Controlling tempo and pace is oftentimes something that most point guards don't really learn until they are pros. But Freak understands how important that is already. It's a big part of why so many think he'll be successful. As a point guard on the next level.
The Texas Longhorns have been building their basketball program over the years. They have been on the verge of greatness for a long time.
I think Texas in general is very decorated.
We got to be more physical on defense.
Still looking for their first college basketball team.
Get into them on the perimeter. Posts. Rotate over and make your presence.
Now here's Freak.
Give me some soft.
Hunting the screen.
Move the ball. Stick it too much.
Livingston kicks to Jennings. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
And I like the fact that the defense is looking to protect the rim at all costs.
Definitely saved a layup with that foul, and he'll make him earn them from the line, and that's what you want to see.
Now Ellis. Livingston, he's in at point guard, and it's Martin in at the power forward. Now the dish to Ford. The shot no good, and the Huskies going the other way now.
And they continue to control the glass.
Guys, I think they've simply been the more physical team, and that's why they're ahead.
Texas trails by six. They really want to find that igniter here.
Yeah, that's right. Kevin, the offense has basically been running in place.
They got to get going. Livingston kicks to Joseph. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. And let's get your take, guys, on the scoring breakdown for the Huskies.
So far, they've turned in a fantastic performance from the three-point line. It's been a weapon all game.
And also, their mid-range game has been impressive. A tough shot to rely upon, but they really had it going tonight.
Keefe is checked in for UConn. Hudson's checked in for Texas. To the middle. And he takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed.
That's what they're hanging their hat on today, fellas. Hard-nosed, smash-mouth play down on the low block.
Old-fashioned, isn't it, my man? Old-fashioned, down-the-rock basketball. And it is definitely working for them.
One thing with Freak that we know is he makes sure he gets his shots up no matter what. One way or another, he's going to get his workout in, and that's why so many are confident that he'll continue to improve.
You're starting to feel it from deep. Let's tighten up our pressure on the perimeter and make those looks tougher to get. We're going to give up the drive, but we have to rotate on the weak side to get there.
It's nice to have a sibling willing to help you develop your skill set on the court.
Pierce has checked in for UConn. Ellis draws the double. Over in the corner, Turner. And Doherty kicks to Ellis. Here's Edwards. And that one goes in as he is fouled. It'll be 3 points if he converts at the line.
Unbelievable basket. I mean, giving up a lot of height there, but he was not to be denied.
Not when the game's hanging in the balance. That makes it a little different. He's going to get to the rim no matter who was standing in the way on that one.
Well, he knew how many inches he had over the guy. I mean, let's face it, good decision to just rise up and take the jump shot.
.137 left here in the second half. Texas trails by six. It's rebounded by Livingston. Livingston's got three rebounds now in this one. And taken away by Ellis. And here's Edwards. Over to the left wing. Hudson kicks to Doherty. And another miss by Texas.
You know, the ill-advised threes isn't how you want to close the gap. They've got to have better shot selection. And you see a lot of players who are very talented play with a me-first approach. That is not the case with Freak. He doesn't try and attract any unnecessary attention and just focuses on playing his game.
Yeah, I like that about him, Greg. I mean, in the day and age where most guys are self-centered and it's all about me, it's refreshing for a player like Freak. He doesn't invite that kind of noise. That's as impressive as a skill set.
The Huskies making a switch here. Splitter's checked in.
Those free throws edge them a little closer. A couple of stops on defense, and they might not be down for long. It's been a good night for Free. He has 11 points, and he's put one three-pointer on the board.
You know what, though, Clark? It wouldn't be a bad idea going forward to try to let him do a little more damage from beyond the arc. It's going to be tough for him here, but maybe, just maybe, it's not over yet.
Cannot afford any empty possessions. They've got to recycle everything, partner.
Edwards passes to Hudson. Lets it go from 14. And it's off the back rim. No good. And an intentional foul right there. He drops the first one, and that makes it a 7-point lead.
Three. Two shots.
So he gets them both, and it's an 8-point game. 23 seconds left here in the second half of the game.
Just too much of a deficit to overcome.
Just not enough clicks and ticks left on that clock in this one, Greg.
Yeah, showing some strength in the paint there. Tough, tough rebound.
Kicks it to McGuire. And a wide-open look for Freak. A chance to extend the lead to double digits, but it's no good. So it's UConn with the win.
Dallas call me. But I'ma get back to the point, baby. Hold on, hold on, hold on, we them boys. Hold on, we them boys. Hold on, hold on, hold on, we making noise. Hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, we them boys. Hold on, we them boys. Hold on, hold on, hold on, we making noise. Hold on.
Hi, everyone. A pleasure to have you join us here tonight. College basketball is in the air, and we are right in the midst of all the action. Kevin Harlan here, along with Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. We've got the UConn Huskies facing Villanova.
And you know, guys, we go back many years broadcasting college games, and it never gets old. Every big-time player makes a name for themselves at the college level, and we could see that again on display here tonight.
Well, with a guy like Freak suiting up, you know that there are going to be scouts watching his every move. But you look at the roster of both of these teams, and they're really loaded with talent.
On the floor for UConn, Livingston. He's in at point guard. Also, Keefe out there. And it's Splitter in at the center position. 13 feet away. Bryant with the rebound.
And the Villanova Wildcats have had a recent surge in their program over the past decade. Since about 05, they have been a consistent presence in the tournament and also have won a few conference titles.
Off target with his three.
I'm shocked that didn't turn into 3 points. I mean, he makes you pay on those nearly every time.
Here's Livingston. Shot is no good. Villanova goes the other way with it. Here's Beal. And you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance to make it three.
Hard to get that one off with the size difference there. That makes it a tough individual matchup for him, especially down low.
Well, took on the big guys going in there and challenging them like he did. But boy, that was a nice job.
Here's Livingston. So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and two shots coming up.
Yeah, nice strong finish there. Nearly a three-point opportunity.
Full throttle, pedal to the metal, attacking basketball. I like that. He's a dead eye at the line, fellas. Just call him automatic. He doesn't miss many of those.
And it's Villanova with the ball. Now here's Beal. A leaner. And that one's good. Beal's got five now.
And he's showing us a little bit of everything now, taking a leaner with no one on him.
Livingston kicks to Martin. Keefe passes to Martin, and it's good.
Wow, what a pass there. He made that a very easy basket with that setup.
Outside Bryant. Beal with it. Out-defended by Freak. There's the pick. Out to Miller. The three. Huskies with the rebound.
Boy, with an open look like that, he is so gifted. Man, you've got to play better defense. Eventually, he's going to make you pay.
Yeah, you can see he's still in rhythm, even though he misses that one almost always deadly when he's that open.
Livingston, no luck. Pass break, Villanova. Miller's got the ball. No good with the layup. Stolen. And here is Beal. 5 points in the game. And out of bounds as the Huskies gain possession. Villanova trails by five. They've got Miller. Cooper is out there at Bryant. And it's Ross in at the power forwards position. Bryant dishes to Beal. Miller with a wide open look. A three-pointer, no good. And for the Huskies, Livingston is in at the point. Also Keith out there. And it's Sims in at the four-man position. Back to Miller. Latrae. Miller with another miss. The Huskies leading by five. Now, Freak. Happy to see that one go in for his second make in five attempts.
Really, the defense is helpless to stop a layup right there. Just too much of an advantage in terms of the mismatch.
The pass to Cooper. Fires at the elbow. No good.
You almost have to assume he's going to knock.
We've reached the end of the first half of play. UConn leads by seven. And time now for the... And the second half of basketball is about to get underway, folks. Welcome back to this broadcast of college basketball here on 2K Sports.
Come on now. Come on now. Let's go.
And while there is a little bit of distance between the two teams, one big run could close the gap in a hurry.
Yeah, I agree with you, Greg. In order to hold on to this lead, they'll need to keep going to Freak to get things working for them offensively. This play in the second half of this game, critical.
They've got Bryant. Cooper is out there with Miller. And it's Ilgauskas in at the four spot. And for the Huskies, Livingston in at point guard. Also Keefe out there. And it's Joseph in at the three.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Yeah, you look across the board, it's actually sizing up, shaping up to be a great game. I mean, strong performances throughout, and they've really been strong on the glass.
And a wide-open look for Freak. Cans the shot with nobody near him. Livingston's got 11 points.
And he could be the guy to put this game out of reach.
Here's Beal, and there's the whistle. Fouled home. Hard on the shot. He'll go to the line.
Boy, how about the Huskies and the success they found in the tournament over the years? I mean, four titles for that program.
And it's Villanova with the ball. Trailing by 13. Shot and game clock separated by five. They double in with Freak. Out to the right wing. And McAdoo kicks to Moore. Jones from outside. The shot is off. Great defense that time from Livingston. Feeds to Posey. He dishes it to Jennings. UConn moving that ball around. Livingston no luck.
Boy, but he was close, Kevin, to making the defense pay for lackadaisical coverage there.
Yeah, you may not be as lucky next time down if you're the defense. You cannot allow him to get those kinds of looks.
The Huskies have won the college championship, Greg, in a number of ways, both as a favorite and as an underdog.
Yeah, I mean, they won as high as the one seed back in 99. And then how about in 2014? They were a seven seed that went all the way to win and cut down those nets. So they have rightly earned every ounce of fear and respect opponents have for them come tournament time.
Brian is out there with Foster. Then there's Cooper. Then it's Miller, and it's Ilgauskas in a power forward. Martin. Bryant with the rebound.
And it's still a close game. I mean, despite the fact that they've struggled to compete on the board.
Yeah, you know, but down the stretch here, guys, they'll summon that extra effort to try and get it done, I think.
Yeah, exceptional play there to take the bump and still get it to fall.
I like to call that stick-to-itiveness, Greg. Getting everything he possibly could out of that play. Nicely done.
Good call.
And Joseph kicks to Livingston to the inside. Martin and two free throws coming up as he misses that one, drawing the whistle on a lot of contact there.
and you don't ever want to get into the habit of letting the offense get to the rim.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you more. I mean, that's the message they were sending with that foul. Nothing easy inside.
Villanova making a switch here.
Beals checked in.
Well, who could forget Villanova and their one college title? Come on now. It was one of the biggest Cinderella stories ever, one of the greatest upsets ever. Winning it all as an eighth seed, knocking down an outstanding Georgetown team back in 85.
Pass to Keith. A minute 42 left here in the second half. Martin, the pass to Livingston. Over to the left wing. Six to shoot. Martin kicks to Livingston. Beal with the steal. And now Bryant pushing it up. No one back to stop him. Finish off the break.
Calm down. We're taking too many shots early in the clock. Let's get some ball movement and run something on the offensive end. Keep it simple. Throw down inside or run some pick and roll.
Beal with the steal. Miller, no luck.
Well, he won't miss many of those, especially with the defender not in the best of positions there.
Well, talking about the Wildcats and what you were mentioning, the improbable title run in 1985. Was certainly the stuff of movies. They got hot, Greg, at the right time.
And they had to take down two number one seeds and also two number two seeds in their path to win it all. Their biggest test being in the finals against the heavily favored Hoyas. It's the defining moment of that program. And so just rolling to the finish line now in what has been a very confident-looking performance for the Huskies.
In the end, they had a better shooting percentage, and that's what made the difference. Sometimes, you know, Clark, things go your way. The other team wasn't catching any lucky breaks themselves.
Well, it's more than luck, Kevin. I think the shot selection was good, too.
And when you look back at this one, what an amazing performance this was for Livingston. Every time he shot it, it seemed like it was going to drop in. And if it didn't, everyone was surprised.
Martin with the bucket.
That one will seal the deal there. They've exploded here at the end.
Boy, I love the serious killer instinct they've shown. Finishing strong.
Here's Cooper. No good. Great D that time from Livingston. The Huskies on offense. They lead by the biggest margin of the game, 15 points. Here's Bryant. Gets to the rim for two with the D all over him.
You know, huge height advantage there, but because of the great body control, he's able to cancel it out.
Agreed. The body control essential in that situation. I mean, if you're giving up a bunch of height, then you better be able to manufacture things in the air.
And so it's UConn with the win.